Namaskarams and welcome back to Munch and Mull. Tomatoes, they are used in almost all parts of the globe in various cuisines. They are rich in antioxidants. Antioxidants, free radicals, cancer, Alzheimer's, Parkinson, lupus, arthritis. Have you heard these words? And they are all related. We'll explain to you in detail in the Mull point, so keep watching. And by the way, today's recipe is tomato rice or Thakkali Sadam with a woman's rice called Poongar Rice. I have used a traditional unpolished or brown rice variety from Tamilnadu called Poongar Rice. It is also called as woman's rice. It is rich in fiber and minerals, especially iron. So it's used for pregnant ladies and lactating mothers. It is also good for diabetics and it's a good source of even antioxidants. And this is how the cooked rice looks. So let's look at the ingredients that go into making the tomato rice. Apart from the 2 cups of cooked rice, I have used Poongar rice. You could use rice of your choice. These are about 3 tomatoes, medium-sized tomatoes, which are chopped, a tablespoon of fennel seeds, 6 to 7 cloves, half a teaspoon of chili powder, half a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 5 to 6 cardamoms, cinnamon sticks, bay leaves, salt to taste, 3 tablespoons of cold pressed groundnut oil, you could use any oil of your choice, and a teaspoon of jaggery. I generally use jaggery because it enhances the flavor of the other spices and gives a little sweetness to the rice, but this is optional. And all these are organically sourced from BioBasics. Start making the tomato rice. I'm adding the oil, the elaichi or cardamom, cinnamon sticks, cloves, fennel seeds or buddy shape. Wow, such a lovely aroma of the spices. Now let's add the bay leaf. Now we'll add the chopped tomatoes, turmeric powder, chili powder, raw cane sugar or jaggery powder. We'll add salt towards the end because when salt is added earlier, then a lot of water loss happens from the vegetable. So a lot of nutrient loss is associated with it. And we will just cook this for about 3 minutes. It's important not to overcook the tomatoes. So now this is done. Let's add the rice to it. This is unrefined sea salt. It. This is an extremely easy to prepare quick lunchbox recipe. Children and adults will love this. Tomato rice could be had with curd or raita, pickle or papad. And you could also make this tomato rice with leftover rice. A tasty, delicious tomato rice or Thakkali Sadam is ready. So here we can garnish our tomato rice with chopped fresh coriander leaves. You could also garnish it with dry fruits if you're sending it in your lunch box for the children. So here our delicious tomato rice using Poongar rice is ready. And as I said, this is a very quick lunchbox recipe. I have not used onions in this. If you would like to use onion, then you can add the chopped onions before you saute the tomatoes. And now for the mull point of this episode. Tomatoes are a very rich source of antioxidants. Tomato has an antioxidant called lycopene and it is supposed to prevent cancer. So fruits and vegetables, and especially colorful fruits and vegetables like beetroot, pumpkins, green leafy vegetables and the gourds, they are very rich in antioxidants. And what are antioxidants? Now coming to free radicals. when there are chemical reactions occurring in the body, there are free radicals generated. Now these free radicals, they are free, so they don't want to be free, they want to go and attack other healthy cells. So these free radicals go and attack the healthy cells, and these are some of the reasons that are causing cancer, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, lupus, arthritis. In the natural process of aging, definitely some free radicals are released. But in today's world, we are exposed to so many chemicals via our food, especially ridden with pesticides and chemical fertilizers and toxic chemicals in the environment, air. So they speed up the process of free radical generation. What do the antioxidants do? Antioxidants are phytochemicals present in green leafy vegetables, fruits, vegetables, whole grains. So these antioxidants, they go and capture the free radical. And so the free radical is not available to cause damage. So can we do something about this? Yes, we can definitely do something about this. So it's important to increase the quantity of fresh fruits and vegetables in our diet, to switch to whole grains and pulses so that we get a good quantity of antioxidants in our diet, and to switch to an organic diet so we are also eliminating the risk of pesticides. There is also documented evidence which says that organic food has a greater quantity of antioxidants compared to inorganic food. So, are you inspired to increase the vegetable and fruit content in your diet, as well as switch to whole grains and pulses to reduce the risk of these lifestyle diseases of the modern world? What do you think about this? Leave your comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. I invite you to join me at Munch and Mull, where traditional flavors meet a green future. Do share this video with your family and friends. Subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon for notifications of newest videos uploaded. Thank you and namaskarams.